Welcome to St. Sebastian Pre-University College. Namaste student. In this video, I am going to explain limiting reagent and excess reagent and also concentration terms. Okay. Now, what is limiting reagent? The reactants that is completely consumed is called the limiting reagent. Excess reagent means the word itself it defines excess, extra, leftover. That means the reactant not completely consumed or used and left over at the end of the reaction are called excess reagent. Okay. Now here product is always depend on the limiting reagent. Limiting reagent question is very important. Usually it is asked for 1 marks. What is the limiting reagent or define limiting reagent? So the reactants that is completely consumed or completely used is called as a limiting reagent. Now example is given here. Before explaining this example, I will explain daily life activity. See here, simple example to explain limiting reagent and excess reagent. See, I have you can see the picture, that is a preparation of 1 cup of coffee. Okay, now how coffee is prepared, that is a normal concept you might be knowing. Okay, now it is 1 cup of milk is required and 2 spoon of sugar and 1 spoon of coffee powder. Okay, now here the picture you can see one cup of coffee required, 1 cup of milk and sugar, 2 spoon of sugar. Okay, but in this picture 1 cup of milk is there. Now here sugar, how many spoon of sugar is kept? 4 spoon of sugar is kept, isn't it? So but according to the preparation wise, preparation is already given. Okay, what is the preparation for 1 cup of coffee? That is 1 cup of milk and only 2 spoon of sugar is required. Okay, now here how many spoon of sugar is kept? That is 4 spoon of sugar is kept. Okay, now in this, of course, 1 spoon of coffee it should be required. Okay, but in these 2 reagent ingredient only I will explain which one is a limiting reagent and which one is a excess reagent. Okay, now here 1 cup of milk, that is for me limiting reagent. It is limited. Okay, it is limited. Okay, but here which one is excess? I need how many spoon of sugar? Only 2 spoon of sugar I need, but how many spoons are present? There are total 4 spoons are present. Okay, so 1 cup of milk will be consumed completely, used completely for the preparation of coffee. Okay, and out of 4 spoon, how many spoon of sugar is used? Only 2 spoon of sugar is used. Okay, so 2 spoon will be left at the end. 2 spoon will be left at the end after preparing a coffee. Okay, so in this only I can explain which one is a limiting reagent and which one is a excess reagent. So here in this cup of milk is a limiting reagent. Okay. And then which one is excess reagent? Sugar is a excess reagent because it is left over after preparing coffee. Which one is left not completely consumed? Okay, incompletely consumed. That is sugar is a it is left over, isn't it? So this is a normal explanation to explain the this is a normal example to explain the limiting reagent and the excess reagent. I hope you understood the concept of limiting reagent and excess reagent. Okay, now I will come back to the chemical example. Okay, that is here zinc sulfide is formed by the reaction between zinc and sulfur. Now here reaction is given. Zn means it is nothing but a zinc plus a sulfur elemental symbol is S. Okay, so zinc sulfide is formed. Now here atomic mass of zinc and sulfur are given. What is atomic mass of zinc? It is 63.5 gram and sulfur is 32 gram. Okay, now here based on the atomic mass, okay, which mass is in a limited amount? Of course, sulfur is in 32 gram. It is in a limited amount compared to the atomic mass of zinc. Okay, atomic mass of zinc is 63.5 gram. That means sulfur, amount of sulfur, that is 32 gram, will be consumed completely during the reaction. Okay, will be completely consumed or completely used by the zinc, reacted by the zinc. So sulfur is called as a limiting reagent. Which one will be present as a excess? Of course, it is a zinc. Zinc will be remained as excess. Okay, or remains unreacted. So sulfur is a limiting reagent and zinc is the excess reagent. So what is the definition of limiting reagent? The reactants that is completely consumed is called as a limiting reagent. Excess reagent means not completely consumed. That means reactants are not completely consumed and left over at the end of the reaction. This is called as a excess reagent. I hope you understood the concept of limiting reagent and excess reagent. Now I am move to the next topic, that is concentration terms. Now, what is the meaning of concentration terms? Okay, now here usually most of the reactions are carried out in solutions. Now what is the meaning of solutions? Solutions means it is nothing but a solute is dissolved in a solvent. Okay, now suppose if I take a sugar solution. Now how you will prepare sugar solution? A spoon of sugar is added to a water. Okay, so in that while mixing you will get a sugar solution. Okay, now sugar is a solute and water is a solvent. Okay, in Kannada I can call it as dravya, dravaka and dravana. Dravana means it is nothing but a solution. Okay, dravya and dravaka, it is a solute and a solvent. I hope you understood what is the meaning of solution. So in solution, how many components are present? Two components, that is a solute and solvent. Okay, now what is the meaning of concentration terms? Here I already told that most of the reactions are carried out in solutions. So in such cases, the amount of substance in the solution, the amount of substance, that is a I already told, while preparing the sugar solution, I will take a spoon of sugar. A spoon of sugar means it is in the form of a mass. Okay, a spoon of sugar may contains 2 gram of sugar or 3 gram of sugar. Okay, so amount of substance in the solution is expressed in terms of concentration. That means 2 gram of solution sugar is dissolved in 100 milliliter or 100 ml of water. Okay, or I can call it as, one more example I can give as 3 gram of sugar is dissolved in 100 milliliter of water. Okay, like that. So this, it is expressed in terms of concentration. So now here in your syllabus, the concentration terms are mass percent, mole fraction, molarity and molality. Okay, so this you have to going to study. In this actually you have to work out a few problems regarding all these concentration. Okay, now next, see the formula for the mass percent. So mass percent is equal to mass of the solute divided by mass of the solution. Since it is a percent, what you should do, this is multiplied by 100. Okay, now what is the meaning of mass of the solution? Mass of the solution, now already I told, solution means there are two components. What are those two components? One is a solute and another one is a solvent. So solute and solvent combine to form a solution. Solute and solvent combine to form a solution. Okay, that is mass of solution is equal to mass of solute plus mass of solvent. Now one more formula, mole fraction. Mole fraction that is a number of moles of a particular component divided by number of moles of components in the solution. Here also particular component means in the numerator it is given as a particular component. Particular component means you can consider either solute or solvent as a component. Okay, but in the denominator, total number of moles of components in the solution, that means you should consider both. Okay, that means number of moles of solute plus the number of moles of solvent. Now what is the formula for number of moles? Number of moles means it is nothing but a mass by molecular mass. Okay, now next formula, molarity. Molarity means it is a number of moles of solute divided by volume of solution in liter. Molality, number of moles of solute divided by mass of solvent in kg. Now I will work out few problems regarding mass percent, mole fraction, molarity and molality. Mass percent. Now formula of mass percent is given as mass of solute divided by total mass of solution into 100. Here now this is a formula. With the help of this formula you have to calculate few problems regarding mass percent. Now here mass of solute divided by total mass of solution. What is the meaning of total mass of solution? This part I will explain, which is there in the denominator. Okay, now total mass of solution means now what is the meaning of solution? As I already told, solution means it is nothing but a combination of solute plus a solvent. So total mass of solution means it is nothing but a mass of solute plus mass of solvent. This you should keep it in your mind. Okay, mass of solute plus mass of solvent. Okay, now we'll work out one problem regarding mass percent. So I will read out the question. 4 gram of sodium chloride was dissolved in 46 gram of water. Calculate mass percentage of the substance in the solution. I will repeat the problem. 4 gram of sodium chloride was dissolved in 46 gram of water. Calculate mass percent of the substance in solution. Okay, so since question is asked about mass percent, now here I have already written mass percent formula. Okay, now according to the question, see what is the, now it is sodium chloride solution that is given. Okay, sodium chloride is a solute and water is a solvent. Okay, so what is the mass of sodium chloride is given? Mass of, according to the question, mass of sodium chloride, this is a solute, sodium chloride is a solute, that is how much is given? 4 gram. Okay, now after that mass of solvent, solvent which one it is a solvent? Water is given as a solvent here in this question. So what is the mass of solvent is given? 46 gram. Okay, now question is asked, what is the mass percent of the substance in the solution? Okay, now here this question I will keep it aside. Now mass of formula already have written here. Okay, now I will not write again. So what is the mass percent? Mass percent, mass of solute, what is the mass of solute? It is a 4. Total mass of solution, now total mass of solution means I already told, what is that? It is nothing but a mass of solute plus mass of solvent. So what is the mass of solute? It is a 4 plus 46. Here it is into 100. So what is the answer? You will get 4 by 50 into 100. Okay, so
What is the answer? It is a 4 to the 8. So 8% you will get. Okay. I hope you understood the question. Now one more problem, I will do it. Now second problem regarding mass percent. I will read out the question. 8 gram of solute A is dissolved in 42 gram of water. Calculate mass percent of the solute. Okay. So I will write the information first. So mass of solute, how much it is given? 8 gram, which is dissolved in 42 gram of water. That means mass of solvent is given. Mass of solvent is given, how much? 42 gram. So which is asked? Mass percent is asked to calculate. So what is the formula? While writing the formula itself, add the formula. Okay, mass of solute divided by total mass of solution. Now here already have written, so substitute the numbers to the formula. So mass of solute, how much? It is 8 gram. And mass of total mass of solution, so total mass of solution means it is nothing but a mass of solute plus mass of solvent. That means 8 plus 42. Okay, since it is a percentage into 100, so 8, how much you will get? It is a 50 here into 100. That is 2 here. So percentage is 8 to 16. So mass percent is 16%. I hope you understood how to calculate mass percent. This problem is very important. Usually this is asked for 2 marks and it is a compulsory question for the examination purpose. Next concentration term is mole fraction. Okay, now mole fraction. What is mole fraction, or what is the formula for mole fraction? So here I have written mole fraction is equal to number of moles of particular component divided by number of moles of components in solution. I will repeat formula for mole fraction, that is number of moles of particular components divided by number of moles of components in solution. Suppose question is asked as what is mole fraction, then you can write this formula itself as a definition. Okay, formula you can write it in a word as mole fraction is a ratio of, ratio means it is nothing but a division symbol. Okay, ratio of number of moles of particular component to number of moles of components in solution. Like that also you can write, or directly you can write the formula, that is mole fraction is equal to number of moles of particular component divided by number of moles of components in solution. Okay, now this is about the formula of mole fraction. Now as I already explained, what is a solution? Solution means it is nothing but two components are present. What is that? Solute and solvent. Solute and solvent. Suppose if I take an example as a sugar solution, how you will prepare sugar solution? Sugar is added to water. So sugar is a solute, water is a solvent. I hope you understood what is the meaning of solute and solvent. Okay, now that means in solution there are two components. One is a solute component, another one is a solvent component. Here I have written, that is numerator, particular component. Particular component means either you can write as a solute or you can write as a solvent. Okay, either you can write as a solute or as a solvent. That is based on the question asked. You can change. That's why it is written as a particular component. But in the denominator, number of moles of components in solution. So number of moles of components in solution means, see, it is simplified again. That is nothing but it is number of moles of solute plus the number of moles of solvent. Okay, so I will repeat. A component means it is nothing but a solute and a solvent. Okay, in solution there are two components, solute and solvent. Okay, Now, so here number of moles of components in solution means solution, it includes both solute as well as a solvent. That's why number of moles of component in solution means, here I have simplified because there is no space to write in this. So here I have simplified, that is, it is nothing but a number of moles of solute plus number of moles of solvent. Okay, so I will work out problems regarding mole fraction. Before calculating the problems, now number of moles. Now number of moles, again there is a formula. So number of moles is equal to mass divided by molecular mass. Mass divided by molecular mass. All these formula you should keep it in your mind. Okay. Again and again while writing the formula, again and again say and write, so that it will remain in your mind. Okay, so number of moles means it is nothing but a mass by molecular mass. This formula, it is used in calculation. Okay, so here there is a question regarding mole fraction. I will read out the question. 0.100 mole of sodium chloride is dissolved into 100.0 gram of pure water. What is the mole fraction of sodium chloride? So mole fraction of sodium chloride is asked. Now I will repeat. Now you have to identify which one is a solute and which one is a solvent. Now sodium chloride is dissolved in pure water. That means sodium chloride is a solute and water is a solvent. Okay, so that is a 0.100 mole of sodium chloride. That means sodium chloride or a solute is given in the form of a mole. Okay, is dissolved in 100.0 gram of water. That means a mass of water or mass of solvent is given. Okay, I will write all the information which is given in the question. So first I will write a number of moles of sodium chloride. Moles of sodium chloride is given according to the question. So that means 0.100 mole. Okay, so which is dissolved into 100 gram of pure water. That means mass of water is given. Mass of water. Water means it is nothing but a solvent. Sodium chloride means it is a solute. Okay, so 100 gram is given. So one is in the form of mole, another component is in the form of a gram. Okay, now question is asked as a mole fraction of sodium chloride. So I will write here mole fraction of sodium chloride is equal to, now particularly it is asked mole fraction of sodium chloride. Okay, so I will write the formula, that is number of, this is, I will keep it aside. Okay, question. Now here formula is given, number of moles of particular component is given. Now number of moles of particular component means which one? It is a sodium chloride. Particular component means it is a sodium chloride. Number of moles of sodium chloride, okay, divided by number of moles of component in solution. Now number of moles of component in solution means it is nothing but a number of moles of solute plus number of moles of solvent. Now number of moles of solute is given, how much? 0.100. So here number of moles of sodium chloride plus number of moles of water. Okay, so I will rewrite it again so that you can see properly. So I will write mole fraction of sodium chloride. This is asked, so I will write the formula, that is number of moles of sodium chloride. Okay, and here number of moles component in solution. So both you should write, number of moles of sodium chloride plus number of moles of water. Okay, so like this, we have to rearrange the formula. Okay, now number of moles of sodium chloride, of course, it is given. Okay, that is directly given, 0.100. Now, in the denominator, number of moles of sodium chloride, again I will write 0.100. Now, plus number of moles of water, but number of moles of water is not given. Instead of moles, which information is given? Mass of water is given as a 100. What you should do, you have to convert mass of water, you have to convert in terms of a number of moles. So I will show how it is converted. So this part I will erase. So this I don't know, number of moles of water I don't know. So number of moles, okay, what is the formula of number of moles? Already I told what is a number of moles formula. It is nothing but a mass divided by molecular mass. Okay, so mass of water, since it is number of moles of water, so mass of water I should write, and molecular mass of water. Okay, so here now mass of water, what is the mass of water is given as 100. So here I will substitute 100. Now what is the molecular mass of water? I already explained how to calculate molecular mass of water, but still I will explain here. Now water, what is the formula of water? H2O. Now in H2O, how many hydrogen atoms are present? 2. What is atomic mass of hydrogen? 1. Plus, how many oxygen atoms present? 1. What is atomic mass of oxygen? 16. So 2 plus 16, what is the answer? You will get 18. So here molecular mass of water is 18. So what is answer you will get? So what is answer you will get as a 5.5555. After 0.4 digit you should write. Okay, now same thing. So I got number of moles of water. So here I will substitute to the main formula. So that is 5.555. Okay, now what you should do, now you have to simplify. So here you have to add first, okay, which is there in the denominator. So you will get this 5.655 and then 0.100. Then with the help of calculator, calculate and write down the answer. I think you will get 0.0176. Okay, so this is a way of calculating. I hope you understood the calculation about a mole fraction. Now one more problem I will do it so that you can understand more clearly. Okay, next problem, that is, first I will read out the question. A solution is prepared by mixing 25.0 gram of water and 25.0 gram of ethanol. Determine the mole fraction of each substance. So both it is asked, mole fraction of water as well as ethanol you should calculate. Okay, now first I will write the information which is given in the question. Now a solution is prepared by mixing 25.0 gram of water. That means 25.0 gram. Gram means it is nothing but a mass information is given. So mass of, gram means it is nothing but a mass. Mass information is given. Mass of which one is given? Mass of water is given. That is a 25.0. Okay. So the next information, and 25.0 gram of ethanol. That means again gram. That means mass of ethanol. Mass of ethanol formula is also given in the question. That is a 25.0 gram. Both are in gram, mass information. Okay. Determine the mole fraction of each substance. Now you have to calculate each mole fraction of water as well as mole fraction of ethanol. But in the previous problem, only one asked as mole fraction of sodium chloride. Okay, here both the component, mole fraction of both the components are asked. Now first we'll calculate. First I will write down the formula, mole fraction. Now mole fraction of water. Okay, mole fraction of water. Now, what is the formula? That is number of moles of a particular component. Which is a particular component? That is this. Okay, number of moles of water and number of moles of components in solution. Now, how many components are present in solution? Solute as well as a solvent. So, number of moles of water plus number of moles of ethanol. Okay, so I will read out. Mole fraction of water is equal to number of moles of water divided by number of moles of water plus number of moles of ethanol. This is a formula. Now here you have to substitute. Now number of moles is not given, but information is given in terms of gram or mass. So what you should do, you have to calculate number of moles. So here I will write the formula. Now first we'll calculate number of moles of water. Okay, so what is the formula for number of moles? Mass divided by molecular mass. Now mass of which one? Since you are going to calculate water, so here you have to write mass of water. Here also molecular mass of water. So what is the mass of water? It is given as 25. Okay, 0.0. What is the molecular mass of water? You already calculated, but still I will again calculate and show you water. So how many hydrogen atoms are present? 2. Atomic mass is 1. So 2 into 1 plus oxygen, 1 element is present. Atomic mass of oxygen is 16. So 2 ones are 2, 16 is 16. So total it is 18. So 18 you will get. Okay, now so with the help of calculator write down the answer. The answer you will get 1.388. okay, so number of moles of which one? Number of moles of water is finished. Now number of moles of ethanol is required. Ethanol formula, it is given in the question, C2H5OH. okay, now here so mass of, again formula, mass, number of moles means it is nothing but a mass divided by molecular mass. Now mass of which one? Ethanol, C2H5OH. Here also mass of ethanol, C2H5OH. Okay, now here, now mass of ethanol, how much is given? It is given as a 25.0. now molecular mass of ethanol you should calculate. How to calculate? How to calculate? That is, there is no place. What I will do, okay, this part I will erase, information part I will erase. So I will show molecular mass of ethanol, C2H5OH. Now how many carbon atom is present? 2 into 12 plus hydrogen. Now here 5 hydrogen, here 1 more hydrogen, total 6 hydrogen. 6 into 1, atomic mass of hydrogen is 1, 1 into 16. Okay, so 24, 2 12 is 24, 6 plus 16. So what is the answer you will get? 24 plus 6, that is 30, 30 plus 16, it is 46. Okay, so molecular mass of ethanol is 46. So here I will substitute 46. Now with the help of calculator find the answer. So what is the answer you will get? 25.0 divided by 46, that is 0.5434 answer. Okay, so this is the number of moles. Now I calculated number of moles of water and ethanol. Now what I should do, I have to substitute these two number to the main formula. This is a formula. Mole fraction of water is equal to number of moles of water divided by number of moles of water plus number of moles of ethanol. So here I will substitute. So this I will erase. So here I will, number of moles of water, how much you got? 1.388. number of moles of water, 1.3888, plus number of moles of ethanol, how much you got? That is this 0.5434. 4. Okay, so what you should do, this part first you have to calculate. Okay, so while adding these two number, you will get 1.9322. So then you have to divide. Okay, so what is the answer? You will get 0.7187. So the mole fraction of water is 0.7187. Okay, so one part I finished as a mole fraction of water. Now question is given, okay, that is determine the mole fraction of each substance. That means which one is remaining to calculate? Mole fraction of ethanol is remaining to calculate. Okay, so I will write the formula. This I will erase. This part I will erase. Okay, even this part also I will erase. Now I have to write the formula for which one? The mole fraction of ethanol, C2H5OH. So what is the formula? Number of moles of a particular component. So which one is a particular component? That is this. So number of moles of C2H5OH, that is ethanol. Here number of moles of components in the solution. In solution two components are present, solute and solvent. So here solute is ethanol. Number of moles of ethanol plus number of moles of water. Okay, as it is, like this only. Now here number of moles of ethanol, how much you got? That is 0.5434. You already calculated and kept. Here you will get same 1.3888, that is number of moles of water plus number of moles of ethanol, 0.5434. Okay, so what is the answer? Here you already written, while adding these two number you will get 1.9322. So what is the answer, final answer you will get? Final answer is 0.2812. okay, so I hope you understood how to calculate a mole fraction. Next concentration term is molarity. So what is the definition of molarity? Here molarity is defined as number of moles of a solute or substance is dissolved in 1 liter of the solution, 1 liter of the solution, or 1 dm³ of the solution. Okay, or you can write the formula itself, that is molarity is equal to number of moles of solute divided by volume of solution in liter. Okay, and it is denoted as a capital letter M. Now we'll work out a few problems regarding molarity concept. Now here I will read out the question. Okay, that is 0.53 gram of anhydrous sodium carbonate is dissolved in water and solution is made up to 100 milliliter. What is the molarity of the solution? Okay, so I will read it, I will read out again. 0.53 gram of anhydrous sodium carbonate is dissolved in water. Okay, now anhydrous sodium carbonate, anhydrous means it is completely dry powder. Okay, sodium carbonate is dissolved in water and solution is made up to how much liter, milliliter? 100 milliliter. What is the molarity of the solution? So which one is given according to the question? Which information is given? 0.53 gram of anhydrous sodium carbonate. Gram means which information is given? Mass information is given. So mass of which one? Anhydrous. Okay, anhydrous sodium carbonate. That is how much? 0.53 gram. Now is dissolved in water and solution is made up to 100 milliliter. So volume of solution is given. Volume of solution is equal to 100 milliliter. Okay, so what is the molarity of solution? Molarity is asked to calculate. Now 100 milliliter, but according to the formula, volume of solution should be in a liter. So what I should do? 100 milliliter I should convert into a liter. Now how I can convert 1 liter? That is equal to 1000 milliliter. So 100 milliliter means how many liter? Okay, so cross multiplication. So what is the answer? You'll get 1 into 100 divided by 1000. So this and this cancel. So 1 by 10. 1 by 10 means it is a 0.1 liter. Okay, I hope you understood how it is converted milliliter to liter. Okay, now, so this I will erase. Okay, so 100 milliliter means it is nothing but a 0.1 liter. Okay, this you should know. Now, molarity formula. What is molarity is asked. So I will apply the formula. Molarity means it is nothing but a number of moles of solute. Now, what is the number of moles of solute? Is it given? No, it is not given. Okay, number of moles is not given. Volume of solution in liter, that is given, 0.1. Okay, so two number of moles of solute. Solute is which one? Solute is this, sodium carbonate. So that means number of moles of sodium carbonate. I am going to calculate. How to calculate? What is the formula for number of moles? It is nothing but a mass divided by molecular mass. Okay, so mass of sodium carbonate, molecular mass of sodium carbonate. Okay, now, there is no space. Here I will erase this part. Okay, then I will continue. Now, mass divided by molecular mass. That means mass of anhydrous sodium carbonate. Here, molecular mass of anhydrous sodium carbonate. Okay, so what is the mass is given here? Mass is 0.53. Okay, what is the molecular mass? Molecular mass of sodium carbonate. Here I will calculate Na2CO3. How many sodium is present? 2. 2 into 23 plus carbon. 1 carbon atom is present. Atomic mass is 12 plus 3 oxygen atom is present. 6 atomic mass of oxygen is 3. Okay, so 46 here, 12 plus 48. So this is 8 plus 2, 10, 10 plus 6, 16, 1, 4, 4, 8, 9, 10. So 106. So molecular mass is 106. Okay, so with the help of calculator, calculate this. This answer you will get 0.005 mole you will get. Okay, now this information where I have to substitute to the main formula. What is the main formula? Molarity means it is nothing but a number of moles of solute divided by volume of solution in liter. Now volume of solution in liter I have already substituted. Number of moles of solute, that is 0.005. So what is the answer you will get? That is 0.05 m. So this is a unit of molarity. To the numerical value you have to write the unit if question with respect to molarity as a m. To the numerical value you have to write the unit as m for molarity. I hope you understood the concept of molarity. Now one more problem I will calculate. Okay, now next problem with respect to molarity. I will read out the question. Calculate the molarity of sodium hydroxide in the solution prepared by dissolving it 8 gram in 250 milliliter of the solution. Okay, calculate the molarity of sodium hydroxide in the solution prepared by dissolving its 8 gram in 250 milliliter of the solution. Okay, so question is asked, calculate the molarity of sodium hydroxide. Which information is given? Prepared by dissolving its 8 gram. 8 gram. Gram means information is given in terms of mass. Mass of which one is given? Sodium hydroxide. This is a solute. Okay. How much? 8 gram. Then volume of the solution. Volume of the solution. This is given in 250. Milliliter. Now how to convert 1 liter? This is equal to 1000 milliliter. So 250 milliliter means how much? So 250 divided by 1000, this one is equal to 0.25 liter. Okay, so I will write this directly as 0.25 liter. Okay, now what is the question? It is nothing but a molarity. Okay, so what is the formula? I will write the formula: number of moles of solute, volume of, divided by volume of solution in liter. So number of moles, it is not given. Number of moles is not given. Mass is given, isn't it? But volume of solution in liter is given. How much? 0.25. So number of moles of solute you should calculate. So what is the formula for number of moles of solute? That is nothing but a mass divided by molecular mass. Now solute means, in this, which one is a solute? That is sodium hydroxide is a solute. Okay, so mass of sodium hydroxide I will write. Here also I will write molecular mass of sodium hydroxide. So mass of sodium hydroxide, how much is given? That is 8. Molecular mass, here I will calculate. NaOH formula is given. Now how many sodium atom is present? 1. 20 into 23. Atomic mass of sodium is 23. Plus oxygen. How many oxygen atom is present? 1. Atomic mass of oxygen is 16. Plus hydrogen. 1 hydrogen atom is present. Atomic mass is 1. So what is the answer you will get? 23 plus 16 plus 1. So 6, 3, 9, 9, 10. 10 here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 40 answer you will get. Molecular mass of sodium hydroxide is 40. Now with the help of calculator, calculate and write the answer. Answer is 0.2. So 0.2 mole. Okay. Now this information we have to substitute to the main formula, that is number of moles of solute divided by volume of solution in liter. So number of moles of solute, how much I got? That is 0.2. Okay, so with the help of calculator you should calculate and write down the answer. What is the answer you will get? That is 0.8 capital letter M, 0.8 molarity. Okay, I hope you understood the concept. Okay, next, last concentration term is molality. See, it is molality. Okay, see the spelling properly. There is a difference between molarity and molality. Now, this is the last concentration term, that is molality. So, molality is equal to number of moles of solute divided by mass of solute in kg. Okay. It is denoted by a letter, small letter M. Now I will work out a problem. See, that is, calculate the molality of a solution prepared by dissolving 149.2 gram of potassium chloride in 800 gram of water. So atomic mass information is given. Atomic mass of potassium is 39.09, chlorine is 35.5. So now we will calculate which information is given according to the question. That is prepared by dissolving 149.2 gram of potassium chloride. That means gram means which information is given? Mass. So mass of which one? Potassium chloride is given. That is 149.2 gram. Okay. In 800 gram of water. Again gram is given. So mass of water is given. How much it is? 800 gram. Now what is the formula for molality? Molality. Okay, so it is nothing but a number of moles of solute divided by mass of solute in kg. Okay, so number of moles of solute, number of moles information is not given, but mass of solute in kg, that information is given. Solute is water, but here it is given in the form of a gram. Now you have to convert into kg. Okay, so how to convert? 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. So 800 gram means how many kg? So 800 divided by 1000 0.8 kg. I hope you understood. So I will write here 0.8 kg. Okay, this I will erase. Now here, so in the place of mass of solute I will write 0.8 kg, but number of moles of solute it is not given. What you should do, you have to calculate number of moles of solute. Solute means which one? KCl, potassium chloride. So it is a mass of potassium chloride divided by molecular mass of potassium chloride. Okay, so mass of potassium chloride is given as 149.2. Now molecular mass, how to calculate? Here I will calculate and show you potassium chloride. Okay, so how many potassium? One potassium is present. Atomic mass is given already. So 39.09 plus chlorine 1 into 35.5. So 39.09 plus 35.5. Okay, what is the answer you will get? It is 74.59 you will get. Okay, so 74.59 molecular mass. So this is, you will get 2.000. okay, number of moles is 2.00 you will get. So here I will substitute to the main formula, that is this number of moles of solute means it is a number of moles of solute divided by mass of solute. In here I will made a mistake, mass of solvent in kg. Okay, so mass of solvent in kg, that is 0.8. so what is answer you will get? That is, yes, 2 by 0.8, that is equal to 2.5, small letter m, that means molality. I hope you understood the calculation. Okay, this is the last problem. By this I am going to finish first chapter. Okay, calculate the molality of the solution prepared by dissolving 60 gram of sodium hydroxide in 0.5 kg of water. Okay, so prepared by dissolving 60 gram of sodium hydroxide. 60 gram means to say which information is given? Mass of sodium hydroxide is given, that is 60 gram. Okay, in 0.5 kg of water, that means mass of solvent is given, mass of water is given, that is 0.5 kg. It is given in kg itself. Okay, now what is a question? Calculate molality. Okay, so what is the formula of molality? Molality means it is nothing but a number of moles of solute divided by mass of solvent. Remember, in previous part while writing the formula I made a mistake. So see here, mass of solvent in kg. Okay, now here, so mass of solvent in kg, how much? This is directly given, 0.5. number of moles of solute is not given. So what you should do, you have to calculate number of moles of solute means which one? It is a sodium hydroxide. Okay, so what is the formula for number of moles? Mass by molecular mass. So number of moles of which one you are going to calculate? Mass of sodium hydroxide. So here also I will write mass of sodium hydroxide. So what is the mass of sodium hydroxide is given as? 60. Now molecular mass I will calculate aside. Sodium 1 into 23 plus oxygen 1 into 16 plus hydrogen 1 into 1. So 23 plus 16 plus 1. So 3 plus 6, 9, 9 plus 1, 10. 10 here it is 40. Okay, so 40. That is, so 60 by 40, what is the answer you will get? As 1.5 5 you will get. Okay, so this is a mole. So number of moles of sodium hydroxide is 1.5. So this numerical value I will substitute to the main formula, that is number of moles of solute divided by mass of solvent in kg. Mass of solvent in kg I already substituted. So number of moles of solute here I have calculated and I will write. Now what is the answer you will get? As this is 3 molality. Okay. So by this I finished first chapter. I hope you understood all the topics of first chapter. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.